Hey guys, just want to get on here and say, tell you a little bit about this video. This is mine and Nikki's time here on the Mardi Gras on its inaugural season. I think we're the fourth ship out, but well, welcome to the video and thank you for taking time and watch it. If you have questions, put comments down below. We'll be glad to answer anything you have for us. Thanks again. Alright, so we're going out here to take a look at the cove balcony. So this is the view you get. You have this big lifeboat. I don't know how that's coming out because I can't see. Right above you, which gives me a lot of shade, you can see here. I'm not direct in the sunlight. Puts a little cast on the water, but look at that blue. You can see the tailings of the ship back there. Ain't nothing out there at all, but just blue. Man, is that blue. That's sapphire blue. I think that might be the bluest ocean I've seen. I don't know how it's coming out on camera, but I don't mind. Yeah, it's one of the perks of the cove balcony, again, is the shade from the lifeboat ahead of you and being real close to this water. It's an angle you can't get from the deck above taking a look at it. But yeah, one more time at the water. I mean, it's sapphires and little light shining back at you here and there. Gorgeous. So we're on our second day of the trip here. I just want to sit down and talk to you. I don't know how the wind is picking up with the microphone. First day was pretty fun. We got on board. Had some troubles with our flight and troubles with our hotel, but when we finally got here, the vacation just seemed to flip. The Mardi Gras is phenomenal. We've been on a few ships now, and this far surpasses everything that we've been on. Food and beverage wise, it far surpasses. Entertainment wise, it far surpasses. They have a lot of grab and go little bites. You can just run around and grab and go, and then they have the buffet like normal. And then they have sit-down dinners. We've done a couple of sit-down dinners so far. This is our second day. We're getting ready to do our slot pool. I just thought I would get on here and talk to you about my experiences so far. The drink package has been really fun to have. And we have the cove balcony, like I said. We decided to do the cove balcony for a couple of reasons. The shade, closer to the water. And it is a little cheaper, too, but I wouldn't say the balcony is a no-go, like, if you don't want to upgrade to it, because we spend so much time, Nikki's come out, we spend so much time out on the boat. This is nice, but I don't know if it's worth the upgrade, so that's up to you, your opinion. If you want to sit out here and hang out, it might be worth the upgrade. So, anyways, just want to get on telling to you about the experience so far. So, just kind of wanted to jump on for a minute and talk to you. I just pulled into Cozumel. They haven't actually docked the ship yet, but I want to show you the water here. I don't know if you can see that as well as I can see that. The coral underneath. You can, we're probably 50 foot of water and you can see straight down, and the blue really starting to lighten up. Well, you can see that. And again, I'm 5 stories up. Every once in a while, there's some fish floating. Pretty clean, well, 5 stories up and see the coral underneath. Yeah. So this is my shot of Cozumel right now. What I'm seeing. Yeah, so getting ready to dock. I don't know how much Cozumel I'm going to explore. Yeah, but love water. Pretty impressive. We'll talk later. So, figured I'd show you the room a little bit. Got to forgive us for, we have been drinking and being merry here on the boat. So, this is what you get with the Cove Balcony Suite. There's Nikki. There's our little restroom. The shower's kind of nice. Check this out. The way this hinge works. A little different. But yeah, your standard, you have to ask for the robes. Get robes. Nice little feature. Decent TV. A little lighting over here. Pulls out. Be nice. She showed me a trick. I decided I'd get on here and film just for fun. That little blue button gives you a blast of cold air in the room. Okay, she's happy about it. She thinks I'm stupid. One more time out on the balcony. We are in Cozumel. So that's a Cove room. We are in 5488. Hey guys, showing you a little bit of the ship. Here we got Emeralds. Back there's your main dining room. That's Palms. That's for anytime dining. Above us, we have the Alchemy Bar. And this is the Fortune Teller. Kind of walk around with you for a little bit. Show you some of the decor on the Mardi Gras here. We're just on the main deck, getting ready to go into Cozumel. We decided to stop and get something to drink before we took it. The time go down. Over here's, I can't remember, some kind of brass bar. They played Mardi Gras themed jazz. Hardest working dude on the ship right there. Okay. Got your Invicta store. This is makeup and shimmer and all that stuff I don't care about. Some more fragrance stuff. If you want to get all foof, they'll even do that here. They got like a salon with makeup and stylists that you can do that on. Here's center stage. I'm going to show you this because I think this is impressive. This is center stage. Great view of the ocean when you're out on it. And everything you see up here, those black points and these brown points, are TV monitors. So center stage. Back here we got the candy shop and the coffee shop and another bar. You are always within 10 feet of a bar in this place or something to eat. It's kind of crazy. And for some reason somebody figured out that they need more bathrooms in this place. So you're always within 10 feet of a bathroom. So that's great. But I'm going to go over here and get me some bottled water. Just thought I'd check in and show you guys around a little bit. We'll show you some more as we go. But for right now, I'm going to get my water and go to Mexico. Give me some tequila. All right, guys. Hey guys, doing again. We're getting back from the port here in Cozumel. Tip to the wise for that. I don't know. Get some kind of mace or something to keep these people off of you because they attack you like dogs thinking they can get a dollar. But it's pretty crazy. They're pretty aggressive cells. But we're here at the port and we saw them. I don't know if we can pick them up in the water here or not. There you go. There's one. Come up, feed. Just wanted to show you that.
We had some fun. We did some tequila tastings and a little bit of this, a little bit of that. You know how that goes. Had a couple decent tequila shots, but yeah, good times. Cozumel's not our favorite port. Like I said, they are way too aggressive trying to get you to buy something. Which I think it's unnecessary because you're going to buy it no matter what. But we got off, we did our thing, we got what we wanted. We were out on the port for about 2.5 hours. We're heading back into the ship. Outside. Big, beautiful ship. We are parked next to the breeze and the symphony of the sea. Those guys, that's a free convenience thing. But nothing in Cozumel's free. You need to tip them. They are working hard getting you to and fro these ports. So, you know, last time me and Nikki did, I think we gave them a $10 bill. And they were okay with that. So, anyways, thought we'd check in, check out. Heading back to the beautiful floating hotel here. Here, look at this. I showed you on video earlier the center stage. Here's the outside view. That center stage window. That big thing. Yeah, back to it. So we're going to go. That was Cozumel. I know I didn't show you too much. It's a lot of touristy shops. Good deals on liquors and cigarettes. And if you want any kind of pharmaceutical, they will do whatever they can to get it to you. So, all right, thanks guys. How's the hair? Let's see. For anyways, how you guys doing? We're in Costa Maya. I figured I'd show you the center of this place. A little crazy. So have a little nice little dining area here, tons of shops all the way around, and then there's this big huge pool in the center with a bar. And apparently they do Libre fightings on this stage here. They're not doing it right now. And you'll see this big walkway. This is some kind of bird atrium or aquarium or something. It's what?
Aviary.
Aviary. And the thing wraps all the way around. There's all kinds of stuff to do. So it's a nice port. We haven't made it to a beach yet, but you better believe I'm going to. We're waiting on a couple Sol beers, you know, it's Mexican beer. But yeah, so I'd show you around some Costa Maya stuff. Just got out of the pool. My hair looks great like this, though. What do you think? Here, let me fix that. Anyways, the pool is salt water. It's not chlorinated, so very salty. Yeah, some place for you to relax, recline. There's some of the birds. I don't know if you can see them there. Let's see if I can zoom in. There's a bunch of flamingos on the other side. Oh, I thought that was my beers. What? I'm getting some sun. Ooh. See you guys. I'm back. Costa Maya is still out. They're everywhere. And then look at this view. Sorry, I was going the wrong way. Ah, if I could do camera work. Sorry about that, guys. I don't want to mess with this guy's day. Let's get up on that. Pod share, there's the big Mardi Gras. Along the pier. A little bit of ocean. Hey, Nikki. Pretty gorgeous. They have this little seating area behind me. right here so you can sit and watch it swing. Pretty cool. Anyways, how you guys doing? We've made it to the Honduras Roatan. Very beautiful out here. Perfect day too. Maybe a little tad hot, but you know, what can you do? A lot of shopping. You know, every port they take you to, there's going to be some shopping. But there's a lot of shopping and a lot of fun stuff to do. We're getting ready to do a chair lift. I'm just going to show you the center of the streets here. Show you what I've got, my view is right here. You can see they got a big fountain, a couple shopping throughout here and here. And if you head this way, that's to the beach. I don't know if you can see, but that's the chair lifts. There's zip lines, all kinds of fun stuff to do here. Like I said, it's a gorgeous day, beautiful place. As far as Mexico, I know Honduras is a different country, but as far as Mexico, this is the most beautiful place I've been to, this side of, you know, they go Caribbean, they go Bermuda, they go Alaska, and then they go to the Western Caribbean, and that's where we're at. So, you know, this is beautiful. Very nice, well maintained, taken care of. Some of the other places kind of feel a little dumpy to me. I'm not trying to be mean, but anyways, yeah, just wanted to show you around. Street view, like you can see like the bushes and stuff. They really take care of this place down here. A lot of pride in it. Say hi, Niggy.
Hello.
All right, guys, we'll show you some more. Hey guys, doing? We are on the chairlift at this point. I got my hat sideways, keeping my ear from burning. Sun's over that way. Woo, hot. Yeah, this is what you're looking at. So, I'll get back on here in just a second when we get a real good view of the water. But this is the chairlift here in the Roatan.
$14.
Yeah, $14 per person. Me and Nikki was 28. But we get these little bracelets and you can get on it all day long. So that's nice. I'll be back. Alright, we're back. I'm going to flip the camera around and give you guys this view here. Start over here. Little, that's a nice little area. Get the ocean out there. Little beach resort thing. And here you go. And the Mardi Gras. Look at that big, beautiful, magnificent thing. That's a fantastic ship. But yeah, like I said, as far as Mexico goes, or I know it's not Mexico, Honduras, but the southern cruises, this has been the prettiest place that I've seen. So there you go.
Can that fly out the back?
All right, guys. We'll get some more footage later. One more water view, sorry. Just for fun here. Just because we're over top of it, and want to show you how clear the water is there. Very pretty place. We're here at the public beach here. I want to show you this. There's plenty of chairs, and you can rent these clam shells, floats, these little floating rings. Looks like all kinds of fun stuff to do, so more coming. All right, guys, back here in Honduras. Me and Nikki decided to do something a little funky. I'm going to show you here.
He said he had the world's most sensitive feet.
I do. It's very ticklish.
Yeah, it's ticklish.
It tickles pretty good.
It feels good, though.
Yeah, so.
They're really getting my heels.
Yeah, they're.
Yeah, they're going for the dead.
Ah! Somebody tickled me there.
Away from
I don't know. Tickles.
Yeah, at first they were there.
They're mostly on my left, but they're staying away from the right foot because they have big toenails on that.
Getting a fresh coconut.
Best way to have a coconut.
There you go. Thank you much. How you guys doing? We're leaving Honduras here. Some good time out there. Did some shopping. Did some sightseeing. I didn't get in the ocean. The sun's pretty hot, and I don't tan. I burn. Typically, I jump at every chance to get in the ocean, but just didn't feel the. It was right today. So I don't want to have the rest of my trip be miserable because I'm sunburned, to be honest with you, so I elected to skip it. We did have some fun. Just wanted to give it one last look. So bad. Within Honduras. And hello, Mardi Gras. That's the last stop on our little vacation, so the rest of the filming that I do is going to all be on the boat, so I'm going to show you a little bit more of that. Right now, I got to go through customs, so see you guys later. Every day while you're on the ship here at Carnival, the guy, or lady, I'm sorry, that comes in to clean your room, leaves little towel animals on your... Pretty cool. Makes your bed up. Empties your trash, just takes care of you, freshens up your towels. My room's still a little dirty, but hey. See, that's clean towels every day. Girl gets you a new mat. Yeah, so that's something nice. My guy's name is Ryan. Coming down to get into my inn. That's Ryan. And back out in the ocean. Not as blue today. Still pretty nonetheless. Anyways, yeah, I just came in to get my swimsuit on, get ready to go do some of the water slides. I tell you what, I've been on this video for a while, and every time my beards look like hell, it's because when I wear these stupid masks. They just mess up my beard every time. But anyways, I'll talk to you later. So one more thing came to mind after I just got done doing that last video. One of our neighbors has been stuck in the room for the last 48 hours. Their door taped shut and they are not allowed out. That would mean, I believe, they have COVID. So COVID is on the boat. I've walked around a lot of the staterooms. Today we did about 4 or 5 levels that I shouldn't have done, just searching for stuff, and nobody else seems to have it. So out of a couple thousand guests, 2 people have it, maybe. So, you know, I wouldn't really call this a cesspool. Everybody talks about how, cruising is a breeding ground for COVID. I mean, 2 out of 1,000. I think that's a worthwhile chance. You know? Yeah, but it is here. So, bring a mask. Sanitize your hands when you can. You know, I believe they either got it at the airport and it didn't incubate till they got here, or they got it in Cozumel on the first day, which feel bad for them being stuck in their room, can't do anything. You know, they at least had 4 days stuck in their room with the ick. Knowing that, I would still risk it to be on the boat and having the time that I'm having. if you're thinking about cruising and you're worried about COVID, I just don't think you should be living your life in that much fear. If you already have the vaccine, well, that just goes to show you the vaccines aren't really working, you know, so they're keeping people alive, when I hear, you know, when you get it, you have a higher success rate. But when you had a 0.000001 risk to begin with of the population to die from it, and most of the high numbers came from you know, nursing homes and elderly or pre-existing conditions of death. So I would not fear COVID and let that deter you from getting on one of these boats. Just that's a personal thought, personal feeling. I'm just sharing it. I'm no COVID expert. And yeah, I don't really know what the hell I'm talking about. I'm just telling you how I feel about it, and how I feel is it's such a low chance. And what they've done when people do have COVID and what they're doing to prevent it, I think the risk is worth it. So, it's up to you. It's your health. It's your life. But I say go live it. Don't hide. Get your vaccine if you're worried about it. Wear your mask. Take your hand sanitizer. Just go have fun. Don't let that be such a deterrent and not be able to enjoy this good time we're having. Yeah. So, shouldn't have said that, all that. I'd probably edit all this out and not do it. No, I'm going to leave it in. So, you guys have a good day. So, I'm going out the room. I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. So, that was my room right there. Nikki likes to foo-foo up her door. And that's what I'm talking about. Taped up room. That's how they do you when you're on board a boat. And like I said, I've walked all the way down this hallways and walked up a couple different ones in the boat. That seems to be the only one. When they all went down to lock that room out, they called a medical code, and it's been the only time I've heard it. So one out of a couple thousand. You know, and we don't know their case or their story. We're just assuming that's what's going on. It's the only reason you would get locked in a room. Anyways, just wanted to show you that. All right, so this area is what they call the Serenity area. Well, I'll start showing you around here. Well, some nice views going on here. Plenty of lounge chairs. Hardest working people on the boat. Right there. And then some smoking area. And we have made it to the back of the boat here. A little more nicer seating here. And you go down. This is an adult only hot tubs, swimming pools, movie stars, you know, all that jazz. Above you is Bolt going off. And the water slides, which I said I'm going to do here in just a few. I get the Bolt earlier today. It's fun. It's quick. I wouldn't say it's worth the money. That's my personal opinion. But that's Serenity. I have masked out because I'm not near anybody. You can do that. I think I'm gonna go downstairs and show you some of that. Get closer on the pool here. Plus, I need to find my wife at some point. This is Shaq's Big Chicken. I'm masked up now because I'm near people. And on the other side's a, well, let's just go look at it. There's an ice cream joint, which is this right here. That's the ice cream place. Another bar. Like I said, you're always within 10 feet of a bar. Inside's the dining. This might get loud. I'm just going to walk through. That's the map of the ship, how you find everything. And here we go into the market dining. This would be where the buffets are and things of that nature. Now they have most of these going all day. They close them down to change it out. A shawarma, gelato, and sea dogs, hot dogs and stuff. Over there is normally your salads, and these are normally your fruits and desserts. And this is main main buffet stuff. There's normally something different on each side, and they have a carver station and some soups. This is your eating stations. A little more secluded. Like if you go on other ships, they're typically just a big open dining hall. This is a little nicer. You can get in these little nooks and have an ocean view. We were in here earlier and that was leaking water. We're gonna keep going here. So, show you this. There are more sea dogs and stuff, but here's your coffee, hot chocolate, hot water, tea, and then they give you lemonade, iced tea, and water free. If you want the sodas, you have to scan your card there. Hand washing stations at every end of the ship, everywhere. You can find a hand washing station very, very close to you. So that's good for the COVID. We'll go down here to the Lido deck. This is the center of the boat. This is where it's going to get loud. This Red Frog bar. Everybody parties here. The main pool. And they've got music going constantly. Show you some more of the eateries. That's the most happening bar in the place. This is Blue Iguana, where you get tacos and burritos. They have breakfast and lunch and dinner, tacos, burritos. Seafood Shack. You buy this, this is extra. There's pricing if you're interested. He's saying hi. This is Fry Time Steam Dream. They have buns and things of that nature. The Mad Sizzle. Did you see the size of the portions that they're given? So that's why I was saying about grab and go. Everything's smaller portioned around here at the street eats. So you can just grab something. You don't have to sit down to a whole meal right then and there. Now I'm going to go do the slide. I just figured I'd get back on here. That was enough little tour. We'll do some more later. I want to show you guys burgers here. Oh yeah, best milkshakes. Best milkshakes are right there. You just make them yourself. So, iced coffee water. This guy's burgers. They have a little toppings bar. Different barbecues and hot sauces. Ketchup, mustard, mayo. Toppings. Chili, mushrooms, onions. And there's the burger joint. So this is what they offer, but you can pretty much order them any way you want. They have, some of them burgers look good. Just filming, sorry. They have all kinds of toppings, chili, cheese, fries. They're all happy to serve there. Look at them guys. There's some happy dudes right there. I just figured I'd show you guys. There's some other places we'll show you later. So let me show you this. This is what they call the ultimate play yard. Let me zoom around. So basketball courts. Up here, some kind of obstacle ropes course thing they got going on with a little tiny zip line that kid just did. And then Bolt over here. But we are heading right around the bay to that big yellow thing. I'm gonna go show you how the fat guy goes down a slide. But more of these awesome chairs. This boat, just if you want to do it, you can do it. Has so many activities. We haven't even touched the comedy. We haven't touched the piano bar, the Havana bar, any of the bands. So a lot more to come. Let me show you this splash pad around the corner while I keep talking. So here's the splash pad. Looks like we got some weather coming in, so I want to do this before that happens. But nice splash pad for your kids. And there are the three slides. My big butt wants to go down the big blue one, I think. So, yeah. Over here you got a little mini golf, which I ain't done yet, and I have absolutely every intention of doing. Looks like a great time. It's a nice little golf course, honestly.
So,
yeah. Of all the ships we've been on, that's the nicest golf course. I mean, that's not a big deal, but it's just like everything else that adds up. So,
are you going down?
Yeah, I'm gonna go get on the slide. So,
I'm gonna sit here.
Hey guys, it's an elegant night here at the Palms. This would be the second elegant night. I just kind of want to show you the dining room here. So this is our view of our table here. And there's Nikki, all elegant knighted up. Anyways, they do a different menu for elegant night. You're not supposed to wear certain things like flip-flops and shorts and stuff like that, button-ups and slacks. Yeah, we're gonna enjoy a meal here. Figured I'd show you the room. We might take some photos of the food as well, so. All right.
Entire restaurant.
Showtime.
You had a mixing day at sea today. Yeah. How was your day today, ladies and gentlemen? All right. Now, we are ready to entertain you once again. We are ready to dance for you and with you. So at this moment, my dear guests, please stand up. Please stand up and please join us, because I have one question for each and every one of you. Ladies and gentlemen, what time it is?
That you like to be my good man. That you like to be.
I think it's relatively stupid that I found this boat, but watch this. So I'm gonna open the door. Come in, this is the restroom. Now I have to stand here and wait this whole time while the door shuts. Very slowly, and then you can lock it. Now imagine having to piss after drinking 20 beers. It's crazy. But just, it's small things. I understand they're doing that more for handicapped people, but I don't want to wait 50 seconds to pee. All right, guys. Probably windy again, but let's take a look at the ocean again today, just because you never get tired of seeing that, right? Look at that. Gorgeous sunset. Thought I saw a bird flying there. Couldn't be though. We're right in the center of it. Takes 2 days to get back from Honduras to Port Canaveral. So on day one, so we are definitely in the center of the Gulf here. Anyway, just thought I'd get back on and show you guys some ocean views real quick. One more night of that and we're on our way back to work. Ugh. Hey guys, we're getting ready to watch the show here. I figured I'd show you the set real quick. I'm not going to film during the show, but let's take a look. So yeah, the whole backdrop's a big TV screen, monitor, projected, I guess. It actually looks pixelated, so I'd say it's a screen. Yeah, pretty nice in here. Good amount of seating. Very comfortable chairs comparatively to the other theaters that I've been in. So yeah, have a good day. Okay, I don't know if I've shown you guys Pig and Anchor. This is what they call the summer landing. It's the brew house. They actually brew their own beer here. Let me turn you around. So this is summer landing. They normally hide ducks, but me and Nikki decided to hide Mardi Gras masks since we're on Mardi Gras. I'm gonna hide one right here. Alright. So this is your liquor shop. Guest services. I got all kinds of different liquors here. Tequilas, vodkas, Jaeger. It's the only Jaeger I've seen on the thing. Bunch of different stuff. Good deals. Buy one, get one half off. And all of it's tax free as long as you only get 1 liter per guest. That's a good bottle. This is what I ended up picking up. It's a Woodford Reserve Carnival Mardi Gras Brew. Only pick that up here, so I got a bottle of that. And I'm debating on getting a monkey shoulder before I leave. Hardest working man in the building, right there. How you doing? This is guys, they got sports here. We watched a football game last night. Good place to hang out. And they have a decent bourbon selection up here. Probably get in there. There's Nikki at the bar. Lots of good things. Like I said, there's always sports going on. This is where the band plays over here in the corner. I think he's playing. Yeah, that's about sad. I think he's playing hurt. Some other stuff outside, pools, go around the outside. And here's guys picking anchor for the boat. Oh, I'm good. I'm just filming. So they got sausages and things like that, chicken, all kinds of good collard greens, baked beans, pork. And then you come around the corner here and you got a little sauce bar. Yeah, it's basically guys. There's a couple other restaurants that I haven't shown on here. Captain's Table, Shebang. Shebang's Chinese and Mexican. All kinds of different things. There's a bonsai. We did a bonsai teppanyaki last night. It's kind of like a Benihana, where they have fun, throw eggs in their hats and stuff. Pretty cool. But I'll show you some more.
So Nikki ordered the Bloody Mary here at the Guys Pig and Anchor. I'm going to show you this, what he's doing. The infused vodka with all this craziness going in the Bloody Mary. It's got onions and olives and carrots and celery and peppers. An olive or two or three. A lime, a celery. And top it all with some bacon. We'll see what she thinks. The world wants to see you taste, Nikki.
Never had a Bloody Mary.
He just shook it.
Oh yeah, he did.
Yeah. Hey, dude. No. There you have it. All right, guys, I'm back. Right here we have Rudy's Sea Grill. This is their menu. Unfortunately, they aren't open right now to show it to you. You guys can pause and look at that. Over here is the panini sandwiches and things of that nature. Smells so good. I haven't had it yet because there's so many food options. And then you got some people on the scooter there, a little Vespa. This is your pizza place. These guys are hardest working dudes on the boat. Good pizza, really. I suggest getting extra sauce on it because the sauce is what makes it. Again, you're never within 10 feet of a boat, or a bar on a boat, sorry. So another bar. I haven't drank anything there, oddly enough. I drank all over this place. This is your Italian eatery, as you can probably tell. They have a build your own lunch. Here's their menu, if you can see that. Nice little place. Nice little balcony out here that you can sit and watch the ocean on. This is where you get to all your photos. I have a couple fun ones there. So, this is what they call pixels. I have a couple few things that you can buy. Earbuds, Bluetooth speakers, cameras, what have you. Camera equipment. And then they're amping up for bingo. I know I told you about the screens. So, you can see the stage and the screens and how that works. Got all these people ready for bingo, trying to win $5,000. Coming around the way, some more shops. This is gold and silver and things like that. Don't talk to them about watches because they'll try to force you into buying one. Hardest working guy in the boat right there. This is the teppanyaki and the sushi place. You can see their little menu there. Whoop, sorry. Some of that. And then these people are enjoying the teppanyaki bar, so I'll show you what that looks like real quick. So, if you've ever been to Benihana's, you know what this is. I really enjoyed it. We had it the night before. It was worth having. We're going to hit one section down. Hit the casino. Just staircase, or you can take the elevator. I didn't care to go down steps, but I absolutely care to go up them. Gets loud in here, as it should. A lot of activity in here. Good bar right here. Hardest working people on the boat right there. That's a lot of fun. Have a little machine there where you can grab hundreds and 500 packs, 250 packs. I've seen a couple people win that. Not often, but I have seen it. It does happen. Here is the Mardi Gras Theater. Here's your show in progress.
Is that correct, Ray?
Right? So yeah, that's some more of the boat. I'll do some more here in just a second. All right, so I'm back on deck 8 here, and what we got here is Chabang. This is Chabang. Kind of fun. I tell you what, let me see if I can show you. These noodles are phenomenal. Really good. One of my favorite places so far that I've ate that's wasn't paid. We're heading into the Havana Lounge. This is the Havana bar. And they have Latin-inspired music at night. That's the hardest working guy in the building right there. Good bar here. Bartender was very knowledgeable. Oh, check this out. This was nice. They have a Domino's table. And I'm a Domino's guy. So that's kind of nice for me. We'll see some more here shortly. So we're going to take another trip downstairs here. I'm going to turn. Alright, so we're going to walk down these steps where all these crazy bingo people are waiting to win money they ain't going to win. Somebody's going to win it, but yeah. This is the big bingo tonight. I have no idea what it costs to get in. I never do. Not much of a gambler. So right here in the front, excuse me, is the gift shop. So there's all kinds of little fun trinkets in there. We bought a couple little things in here, not much. So if you ask me, they're way overpriced for their carnival merchandise. It's like $50 for a t-shirt. They got a Invicta stand going on and 2-for-20 t-shirts. That's the way to buy them right there. The Alchemy Bar. And below it is the fortune teller, which I'm pretty sure I've shown you guys already. All that. So, yeah, it's a little more of the boat. Let me take it back here to the Limelight Lounge, show you that. This is where they do a lot of punchliner comedy and trivia.
Number 13. What did East Pakistan become after a devastating civil war?
So yeah, nice little theater for trivia. Anyways, next up we'll do another bit of the boat. If I can think of anything else that I've missed, I will film it. But for now, I think we're going to call the filming over and say thanks for watching it. You know, we had a great trip. There's a lot to do on this boat. You'll never do it all. The bands are great. The entertainment's great. The food's great. The pool's all over this place. The water slides are super fun. The boat roller coaster is fun. You get on this boat and you're going to have a good time. The staff here seems super friendly and glad to be back to work. You know, COVID really put a big damper on, you know, the cruise industry. Really hurt these people. So if you get on, tip them nice and take care of them. They've been hurting for a long time. But anyways, yeah, great ship, good times. So glad to be back cruising. I'm going to go relax in a hot tub and maybe go down a water slide. We got some packing left to do and some eating and drinking left to do. So You guys, I appreciate you taking your time and watching this video. And till next time, we got another cruise coming up next month. I think we only got 21 days till we're back on a boat, so we'll have a new video coming up. Thank you.